answer to the next question now. What is the next question? Mention the following two examples of social practices prevailing. Two examples of social practices prevailing. Two oppressive policies of the British. Two ways in which common people suffer. Four reasons for the discontent. What is the meaning of the word discontent? Dissatisfaction. There is no satisfaction that led to the 1857 War of Independence. Shall we move into the answer now? To start with the answers, the social practices which was prevailing in the society is untouchability and child marriage. What are the social practices? Yes, it is untouchability and child marriage, which took the society backward. These are the evil practices which took the society backward during the rule of Britishers. Next, the two oppressive policies. What is the meaning of the word oppressive? Subduing someone, suppressing someone. So this is made by the Britishers. They imposed heavy taxes on high import duty. When native people have an idea of importing their goods, they imposed heavy taxes on the goods. When native people, Indian people, they have an idea of importing things, Britishers, they imposed heavy taxes on things. And Regulation 3 passed in 1818. What is the regulation passed in 1818? Regulation Act 3. It is nothing but a native people could be jailed without listening to their sentence. They are jailed without listening to their reasons. So this is the regulation which was passed in 1818. These are the two things which is considered to be the oppressive policies which completely oppressed the native people. The native people could not bear to it. So here for first question I have given you some ideas, and for second question I have given you ideas. When we move on to the third question, here you can see common people suffered. They lost their jobs and lands. They were being converted by the British. The measure which is taken by the British government, it made the common people to suffer a lot. They lost their jobs, they lost their lands, and they were being converted by the British people. Next, here four reasons for discontent, for satisfaction, for not being satisfied, dissatisfaction. Indians were enslaved. According to the Regulation Act 3 in 1818, they were enslaved. Cottage industries were destroyed. Indian sepoys were humiliated. What did the Indian sepoys do? They were humiliated by the Britishers. Indian customs were abolished. These are the four points, four reasons why there was a dissatisfaction which led to a revolt and which led to a first war of independence. Indians were enslaved. Cottage industries were destroyed. Indian sepoys were humiliated. Indian customs were abolished. Are you clear with the points, children? Pause the video and take down the points if you need the points. You have to frame your answer with these points. Next, the next thing which we are going to discuss is, listen to the exercise, children. When you turn the pages of your textbook, there you can see a picture of something. A picture of a goat and a fox, cunning fox. So what we are going to do next? Is there any idea? Is there any guess what we are going to do next? Okay. The next topic which we are going to see from your textbook is story writing. What is the topic we are going to see? It is story writing. You all know to write stories, where you will imagine and you will write things out of your imagination. Is it clear? You will imagine things and you will write stories based on your imagination. But what you are going to do here with this textbook exercise is, now listen to the session carefully. Story writing, you have to do this work in your homework notebook. Be careful where you are going to write the story. You are going to write it in your homework notebook. The answers of the questions in your classwork notebook, here give a heading as story writing. Give the date of today. You are going to write the story. You are not going to imagine things. Pictures are given for you. You are going to write stories with that. See, in your textbook you can find these pictures. A picture of a fox who accidentally falls into a well. First picture of a fox who accidentally falls into a well. What you are going to do now? With these pictures, you are going to develop your story. Okay. So, this is the first picture for you where the fox accidentally falls into a well. And next, when he falls into a well, he is thinking of ideas how to get out of here. Okay, when the fox is inside a well, he is thinking for ideas how to get out of here. At that time, one more animal is visiting the well. Who is that animal? Yes, it is a goat. Who is the animal who is visiting the well over there? It is goat. And he is questioning the fox. What is the question he is asking? Hello, is this water sweet? What are you doing inside the well? The goat is asking a question. Hello, is this water sweet? What are you doing inside the well? Children, here I would like to tell you one more thing. Have you listened to such stories from your grandmother? Or have you listened to such stories in YouTube? Or from the children channel like where you have the story narration channel, TV channels? So this would be a familiar story to you. Is this a familiar story or not? How many of you have listened to such stories? See, when I was doing this PPT in my home, when I was just snipping all these pictures, cutting the pictures and pasting it, my daughter, who is of 4 years old, she told, Mama, this story I know. I have seen this story in Chutti channel, Amma, or I have seen this story in some of the channels. So, this is a very familiar story for you. My daughter told like that, Mama, I know this story. I have listened to such stories. This story about a fox and a goat, I have seen this in TV, Ma. She was telling like that. I was really happy. Do you have the habit of writing stories, children? And if I am going to ask my daughter, I am sure that she will narrate the story. Do you have the habit of writing stories? If you don't have the habit still, start doing that. With these pictures, you could write your own story. So here you could see, when the fox accidentally falls into a well, he doesn't know how to come out. At that time, an animal is visiting a well and it is a goat. He is asking the fox what he is doing inside the well. The fox is replying, you can take it according to your imagination, how the fox is replying. And the goat adds to his idea. He is asking, is this water sweet? What you are doing inside the well? And there you could see, when we advance to the next slide, you could see, just to see the picture, children, too sweet. The fox is replying that the water is too sweet. I have had so much, I might faint. The tasty water is making me to faint. I am just enjoying the taste of the water. Now, when the fox is replying in this way, we know the character of a fox, how it will be. It will be cunning in nature. It will be curious in nature. And we all know that fox is also intelligent in nature. So here, when he gives a reply like this, the goat is also interested in tasting the water. Let us move to the next slide now. Now, after the goat comes into the well, now what the fox is doing? He is getting the help of the goat to move out of the well, to jump out of the well. With the help of the goat, the fox is jumping out of the well. And finally, you can see the goat worries. Because he comes to know that he got cheated by a fox. My mother used to say, be careful how you take the advice of people you don't know. So here you can see the goat got cheated by a fox. So here the goat could just recollect the advice of his mother. And there the story ends. Followed by the pictures, you can see some questions. What you are going to do, ask one another questions about the picture. Now, whereas you don't have a situation of sitting with your friends and asking questions to your friends, you are going to write the answer for all these questions. Once you write the answer for all these questions, you'll be able to frame a paragraph over there. What you are going to do now, you are going to write down the answer for all these questions. If you write the answer for all this question, you can frame a paragraph. Is that clear for everyone? Next, when we move on to the next slide, what you are going to do? You are going to write it in your rough notebook, children. Be clear. You are going to write it in your rough notebook. First, you are going to write down the answers in your rough notebook. Write the story in your own words in a rough notebook. Then you can copy it to your homework notebook. If you are not confident with the answers, write the answers in rough notebook. When you frame it as a paragraph, you can do it in your homework notebook. Write the story in your own words. Give it a title. What you are going to do? You are going to give a title for it. You have to give a title. You have to write the moral. What is the message conveyed through the story? Will you give a title and will you give a moral for it? You have to make the story go for 15 lines. Is it clear? You have to make the story run for 15 lines. And where this work should be done, children? It should be done in your homework notebook. What is the title you are going to give? Story writing. And if it is possible, you can just draw what is the art given in your textbook. If you have time, you can do it. Story writing, practice it in your homework notebook. Next, later we will write it in your composition note. Will you do it? You have to write the heading as story writing, give a title for a story, write the story, and what is the moral conveyed through the story you are going to write. Thank you, children. Do the work which is given. I'll meet you in the next session. Bye-bye.